The thing that's such a blessing about being here today and all these people who served and volunteered their time, our desire was to bless a lot of nameless faces. I'm not going
to remember. Such an opportunity to witness and to see God work in the hearts of people across the state. Thank you.
Amen.
Our program and policy council leaders who made this campaign not a campaign of hate or disparagement of any group, but a campaign of love. Love for God, love for His Word, love for families, and love for children. They started out on that note, and they kept it that way, despite what came against them, and I appreciate that.
Praise God. Arizona's going to pass it too. Thank you so much.
What's going on with other groups that are fighting us? They're supposed to be pro-family groups, and she was always praying, feeding me scripture, interceding
for us. God kept saying to John, I can do this. And at some point in the middle of that process, I probably believe John met the Lord and said, I'm right here. You just tell me what to do. And
it's victory, and I'm just thankful that He would let me be a little part of it.
The folks who are the professionals, the trained professionals, that were behind the scenes, they did this. And you know, Nathan was my right hand. He did all the grassroots organization. That was his role, is to communicate with you, is to network with you, and to be plugged in. And he did just really an outstanding job. Lamar Smith was our North Florida guy. I said, we need somebody that can talk like this and's got a pickup truck. And we found him in Lamar Smith. Because he traveled all over North Florida. And really went church to church, house to house, in some of these counties where there's just, you know, population 432, and sometimes less than that. He actually was up there and really networked all those little small counties up there, and we are very grateful to you, Lamar. Many of you know, many of you don't know John Domay, but he networked churches. He did the church action kits. That was Clayton Clore from First Baptist Central Florida's idea, but John executed it, did it with great skill, did some of our automated calling efforts, and was just all over all the church activities, and we're grateful for your participation, John. Gabe Rodriguez, this guy is the man. He did all the Facebook, the MySpace, all the website back-end stuff, and all that. Everybody that knows me knows this man right here, Rafael Neves, because I didn't go anywhere without him coming with me. He was my bodyguard. He was my driver. He was my personal assistant. He basically carried my coat during the entire campaign. He's very gracious. To know her is to instantly be ingratiated to her kind way. And she helped do fundraisers all around the state, organize them and plan them, and really helped us to raise the money that we needed to do everything that we did. And so that was a real critical part. This man here is Paul Carvalho. And I got to tell you, actually, Tomas Lars just walked in the door. He was my champion in the first part of the campaign for Latinos. But Tomas got sent by the Lord to work for Lou Engle in the call, and so he went out to Kansas and California, and I had no Latin leadership, because no habla español, white boy. And so I kept meeting Paul. I went to a banquet, a pro-life banquet, sat right next to Paul. It was like, I just started talking to him. It was like he was an instant connection. I had a word from the Lord. I prayed for him. It was just a very interesting connection that we had. I went to another meeting and I saw him down in Miami. I couldn't get away from this guy. Found out he was in between jobs. He had had a history as a pastor and a worship leader, and worked for a very prominent evangelist around the world as an interpreter. And so I was like, wow. And so basically we hired him in Miami to network all the Latin American churches. And that was a key part of our strategy. We needed to get oxygen from Latin American voters, from black voters, and from Catholic voters. And Paul Carvalho was that person. So we are very grateful to you, Paul. Then I discovered, I hired him to network churches, but then I discovered a greater gift. He was our spokesperson. We actually had him go on a TV show, and he did an incredible job. And so we basically cut him loose, and he went, did all kind of media and TV, Spanish TV, and even English-speaking TV, and was a great advocate for our cause. So this is the staff.
Great is thy faithfulness, Lord unto.
are near to you, but you clothe yourself with frail humanity. You did not wait for me to cry out to you, but you let me hear your voice calling me.